this. You've got to start with this.
My name is Claudia Castro. I'm the Managing Director of Smart Growth Forsyth County. We welcome you. We ask you to please be polite and remain courteous. This is an opportunity for you to really have an intimate look at your candidates. And with that, I would like to turn the forum over to Bob Slaughter, who is Smart Growth's founder. Thank you so much for coming.
Well, good evening. Thank you all for coming. Thank you, Claudia, for putting this together. We founded Smart Growth in 2005 specifically as a nonpartisan organization and truest to the community roots of being entirely grassroots, entirely volunteer organization, open to all. And we have maintained that nonpartisan stance and actually guarded that stance over the years, and we will continue to do so. In that discussion, in your opening statement, if you can get to it, please list in priority what you think the top three challenges are to both the county and your district in specific. We'll start with Brian Tam, District 2 incumbent. Brian?
Ready? First of all, thank you very much. Appreciate you taking the time to come out and your interest in Forsyth County government. My vision really started 8 years ago when I took office, shortly after realigning the Mathis Airport Parkway. I sought citizen input, and that's what it begins with, citizen input, for the Peachtree Parkway overlay. It speaks to standards for the architectural landscaping and setbacks along 141. Moving forward, I see a CID formed, Community Improvement District, for 141. I've presented this to the General Assembly and to the Chamber of Commerce, and I think by this time next year, it can be a reality. I see continued enhancement of what I call the Big Three: education, recreation, public safety. As a commissioner, it's paramount to work with other branches of government. I've sat on local school councils for the past 9 years.
Brian, can you speak louder, please?
Absolutely.
You may stand. If you want to take the podium, you can do that.
No, I'm okay. And working with the school system has resulted in joint venture recreation, outdoor classrooms, and infrastructure sharing. Moving forward, I sit on the advisory committee for North Georgia College, which, if you don't know, in August, will open its doors to Forsyth County residents. They're building a new campus right up on Pilgrim Mill Road. We must support the continued expansion of higher education in our county. Recreation. Within the next 30 days, over 250 acres of passive and active recreation will open for the public to enjoy in South Forsyth. This is a result of the Parks Recreation and Green Space Bond that I initiated. I think we should familiarize ourselves with the master plan. That's the Parks and Recreation Master Plan. And continue investing in these amenities as they add property values and will help our local economy. Public safety. I was able to work with other branches of government to help bring a sheriff's precinct next to South Forsyth High School. Moving forward, we need to continue to invest in public safety, adding fire stations, law enforcement facilities, and fire engines, mostly using sales tax dollars, as we've done in the past, that keeps our property taxes low. Overall, I think we should be investing in interconnectivity with sidewalks and multi-use trails similar to the ones that are being added to the Old Atlanta Corridor. We need to encourage quality, well-placed development, such as the Avenue Forsyth, hopefully bringing the Talbin Project to fruition, and the expansion of children's health care that will complement our already existing quality health care system and provide quality jobs for years, if not decades, to come. I see the elimination of private sewer plants, and I'm at 250. You said 250.
10 seconds.
the elimination of private sewer plants, and the cooperative solution with the city of Cumming for a redundant intake.
Okay. Thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
Can I?
Mr. Brown, sure.
You might be able to hear me a little better. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dennis Brown. I'm running for commission in District 2. I've lived in Forsyth County for 14 years, resident of Cobb County originally, and we live in a wonderful county. So I've got a prepared statement here. I think I'm going to spend a lot of time on it, and I'm going to defer to it. Quality, 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 not quantity. My vision is for Forsyth County to be the global destination of choice for quality, top-tier business and residents, a county that is safe to walk the streets any time of day or night, a county that recognizes and preserves its natural resources and beauty while maintaining quality schools and resources to attract high-tech business startups and global Fortune 500 companies and headquarters. In short, a place that all residents are proud to call home. We need to remain a premier county nationally and not make the same mistakes that many other high potential counties have made, falling victim to urban blight and overgrowth. Our Forsyth should have world-class amenities constructed and maintained with an awareness and respect for our natural beauty and resources already present in Forsyth County, blended naturally to preserve our heritage of the past with a strong and vibrant vision for the future. We proudly call Lake Lanier ours, which is a vacation destination in our own backyard that we must maintain. Forsyth County represents the mountain gateway to North Georgia, close enough to Atlanta, but far away to maintain a much better quality of life. In Forsyth County, we are uniquely positioned to have it all. We have done a lot of great things. If we can continue to build on what we've done, I think Forsyth County can be a global destination, both residential and business-wise. And there's a lot of details within that. The three topics that I see are the most pressing issues are growth and development, transportation and congestion, and water. And I think those are the same for the county as a whole, notwithstanding Lake Lanier. Growth and development, the county will grow. It's inevitable. It just depends on how much, how fast, and how fast and how much. We need a balanced growth policy that will allow us to maintain the quality of life, yet sustain a reasonable tax base for our infrastructure requirements. And I will say District 2 South Forsyth is under tremendous pressure from special interests and these other developers and moneyed interests to grow faster than it is prudent. And I think a lot of counties have made a mistake by buckling under to that money. So we must resist the urge to grow for growth's sake. I stand for well-planned and quality growth in all cases. Traffic and congestion in some counties grew. They just went and said, okay, the more roads we build, just make them wider, longer, faster, put more red lights in, and it'll fix itself. Well, we see where that's gotten us. Better traffic engineering that'll improve traffic flow without paving more of the surface area is the key. There's a lot of roundabouts are an excellent idea. They use them in Europe. You don't have to come to a complete stop and you yield. It's an excellent idea. And you know, look outside the zone there. It keeps balanced quality growth. It adheres to planning overlays and the UDC with minimal variances to existing buffer zones. And then water. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I have to stand up here. I might sweat all over this table before the evening. I'm John Durucki. I'm running for County Commissioner in District 5. I had a prepared statement, but when you're talking about vision, I felt like it was better to come up here and speak to you from my heart. You know, I think we live in a wonderful county for a lot of different reasons. We have beautiful natural resources like Lake Lanier. We're at the foothills of the mountains, but at the same time, you know, we can get to a metropolitan area like Atlanta and enjoy restaurants and entertainment. Sporting events. We're close to transportation with Hartsfield-Jackson Airport. You can literally drive to some of the greatest places in very few hours, whether you want to get down into the Panhandle or in one of my favorite places to vacation is over in Charleston. There are a lot of things that drew myself and my family here. You know, particularly Lake Lanier was one of those. We've always lived near a lake. And when you have all of these beautiful natural resources like we have at our destination or at our disposal, plus you have a wonderful educational system, I can't think of a better place to live. And that has a lot to do with why I decided to run for county commissioner, because, you know, part of my business is that I truly believe that we're at a crossroad. And we can either veer off into the wrong direction or we can veer off into the right direction. And if we're going to continue down the right path, then we have to learn how to handle all of this growth and balance it at the same time. You know, we have to maintain the quality and value in our homes. We need to promote and protect Lake Lanier, just as we will do with all of the natural resources that we have here. And, you know, for some of you that don't know me, yes, I've been in the construction business my entire life, and I can tell you one thing. I know the difference between good developments, and I know the difference between bad developments. And I do see a lot of bad developments. I'm not saying that they're all bad, so please don't leave here tonight and misquote me and think that I said that, you know, Forsyth County has fallen apart, because that's not the truth. We do have some good developments here, but we also have some terrible developments here. And that's not a subject that I think that I need a lot of training on or a lot of speed to get hooked up to and moving in the right direction. You know, I own a small general contracting firm here in the county that I started in 2005. We're very focused on the kind of work we do. We love to concentrate on LEED projects, which is leadership in environmental and energy design. We don't do any kind of public work at all. So, you know, I know not too long after my announcement and after SPLOST was passed, somehow I was awarded the jail and courthouse without a public bid, but I'm here to put that rumor to bed. You know, I can tell you, if I am elected county commissioner, we will never do a public job, not as long as my name's on the sign. So, but what I see for us is creating a balanced growth. And that has everything to do with protecting natural resources and maintaining the value of your property. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Hart.
I might as well stand up as well. I didn't know the coffee was caffeinated. So if I start getting like this, know that I ain't used to caffeine. I drank decaf, so I'll be drinking coffee and chasing it with water to try to fizzle it down. But my name's Tim Hooker, and I'm running for Commissioner Post 4, or District 4. I'm still used to the old way that we call them posts. Been here all my life. My family's grandparents, they was here. I've been very blessed to live in Forsyth County, and I count it on. To be here. When folks ask where are you from, I say Forsyth County. And I'm proud to it. You know, a lot of folks have up and moved and went somewhere else because they didn't like Forsyth because of certain things that might have been. I love Forsyth. I mean, I know we have grown in population, but I remember as a child whenever we used to have to drive to Doraville to go eat out, go to Lionel Play World when I was a child. And I'm thankful that we have had some growth, but I believe, and one of the things I believe we can still have growth and still have life is we've known it in the past and it be not reckless. I know some things other counties have got reckless with their growth and trying to juggle it and dropping it. And I believe we can do this in a way that we can be balanced and be equal and still be able to have a good place to raise our children and grandchildren. And that's, you know, that's my vision. I didn't bring a statement. I'm the same way. I just speak from my heart because that's the way I am. My family, we started a business and, oh, okay, I didn't know what's happening. Because I don't know the menu. Thank you. But we started a business, my grandfather did, a trucking business in the early 40s. and we still do that today. My other grandfather, they was in the lumber business in the early teens, and they're still in business today. And we've been in construction all our life, and we also know how I like to see things, a lot of things left alone, but I do know that we have to be able to grow, and in order for folks to come and want to live here, we need jobs for them, and that's something we need to work on. Oh, 3 seconds, 30. Okay. I'm sorry. I'm a little scattered from time to time, but like I said, I love Kent, and I don't want taxes to get out of hand. I'm afraid of that. I want things to stay balanced, and I want us to be able to reduce the budgets now and start now instead of waiting until we're in trouble. Right now, I don't believe we're in trouble, but if we continue the way that we're going, I believe we'll be in trouble in a few years. So, thank you very much.
Actually, I wanted to get up. I'm not fidgeting over here, there's gnats that are just driving me nuts over here. So, all right.
Sure, Bill.
I think Cindy planned it. All right. My name is Bill Mulrooney, and I'm actually going to try to answer the questions as opposed to talking too much about myself. I have a website, BillMulrooney.com. A lot of the things, a lot of the issues I put on my website, for instance, my opinion on the Big Creek watershed, the whole thing, that's on my web too. So if there are any questions you don't get answered tonight, BillMulrooney.com. All right, I define our county in several different ways. We're unique that the southern part of the county is more of a bedroom community. They're more dependent on Atlanta and outside the county. Then we have the city, which of course is a whole other topic. And anybody who's ever been shopping at the Publix at Hammond's Crossing on Memorial Day weekend knows that the vacation aspect of Forsyth County is very valuable to our economy. I live up that way, I live about a mile off the lake, and Saturdays in the summer is just crazy at the stores. But then also up in our district, in District 4, it's very rural, and we like that. My wife and I moved here back in 2000, we grew up in Snellville. And if anybody has seen Snellville lately, you know that's not the same as it was back in the 60s and 70s. And that's kind of one of the reasons we're here, because we wanted to move back to a place that was like Snellville used to be. I don't want to see Snellville in District 4. But the biggest problems I think that the county's facing in the future, the next 4 years, first off, jobs. We've got to quit redefining, jobs in this county as retail. Retail's great, but it's not a creator of growth, it's a byproduct of it. Nobody says, let's build a Walmart and people will move here. We need to attract real businesses offering real businesses and attracting real employees. I've spent the last 25 years working with international manufacturers. This is kind of my niche. I know what these people look for, I know what they want. That's what we need to do. We need to get real companies here offering real jobs so that we all don't have to spend $4 a gallon and drive 100 miles round trip to get to work. Our budget-wise, another big thing facing the county is our budget. We've just passed this $200 million SPLOST. We now have to meet all those requirements, all those obligations that SPLOST has given us. We now have to meet those, and we have to be careful. We have to be smart, because we cannot do it by raising taxes. We're going to build all these capital equipment projects, but then we're going to have to fund it. Then we're going to have to operate it. And we have to be really careful. We do not want we cannot raise taxes to do it. I also believe we need to be water independent. We need to be self-reliant. The county is the main water customer in this here, so we need to be self-reliant on water. District-wise, I think district reps spend, there's two jobs of the county commissioner. One is looking at the county as a whole, and the other is looking as a commissioner, representing the homeowners. Representing the homeowners in my district. That's the important part, because too often we've been ignored outright. 10 seconds, please. Anyway, the biggest problem with my district right now, we're gonna fix on July 31st. Thanks.
Sit the gnats back their way. I want to apologize. I usually try to fix up and look a little bit better, but I've been to the 4-hour commissioner's work session. 5 hour. And it was a rough one. A great American, John Wayne, said, and he even has it written on his tombstone, tomorrow is the most important thing in life. comes into us at midnight, very clean. It's perfect when it arrives, and it puts itself in our hands. It hopes we've learned something from yesterday. My vision for the next 20 years for our county involves taking a look back at our past. Those things that were precious to my great-grandparents that lived here, our forefathers, should remain, and we should carry those qualities into our future. Being good stewards of our land and our water while protecting our property rights, caring for those in need, surrounding our youth and our elderly with loving care that promotes education and healthy living, and pursuing a thriving economy. The county faces challenges economically in balancing its tax digest as property values decline, challenges with maintaining our quality of life with our parks, our roads, our libraries, and our public safety with lower tax revenues and escalating operating costs, and challenges that come with wanting to attract quality businesses while protecting our environment. I feel these challenges in our county are the same that's in our district, and a balance can be achieved with adequate planning, stellar leadership, and a community effort. Having a vision for the future, a vision of water independence, a vision for producing more jobs, a vision for a thriving Forsyth, are all the first steps in achieving our goal of a better Forsyth. We need to get back and look back at our forefathers and what they intended in having a government for the people that serves the people instead of serving itself. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You get bonus points. You only have 2 minutes.
I know, I should have taken up more time.
What time can you
do this? I have to go off.
I'd like to give Ms. Chairman Boff an opportunity to give an opening statement since he's coming in late. Is that okay with everyone?
Sure.
Good? Okay, so Jim, what we did in the beginning, the first three questions that had been sent to the candidates where you were to describe your vision in 250 words or less for the next 20 years was combined with identifying what you think the top three challenges are both to your district and the county. So if you could try to put that together in about 3 minutes worth of time, which is what everyone else had, you get a chance for an opening statement. If you want to step up front, you can, if you're more comfortable. He is artistic direction here, so.
I know what happened last time, somebody didn't do what she wanted. Thank you very much. I'm sorry I was not here. I just came back from an executive session and commissioner meeting right before that. Vision for 20 years. I don't have a 20-year vision, I'll be honest with you. My vision goes out maybe 10 years. I believe the county is already positioned very well, and it's now it's time to take advantage of and to pay off some of the nice things that we have come to have in the recent years. We're going to have enough trouble, I believe, paying for the operations of some of those nice things. And I also believe that the global economy especially is in such an unknown state at this point that any additional major expenditures that are not already pretty well known, whether you like them or not, by people, it's not a good time to entertain things like that. I believe we should pay down debt where we can, consider collecting fees, perhaps new ones, for usage of some of these things if we can and it's acceptable to the citizens, just in general enjoy and hope that some of these things do in fact attract people who would like to pay some of our SPLOST tax for us. So my vision is essentially to continue with what we have in terms of some of the other things, of the major problems. First of all, by and large, I ran the first time under the assumption or the premise that we didn't have a lot of major problems, and I still believe that. I'm not to say we don't have problems, but the finances are pretty good in the county. We have plenty of green space. We have plenty of the things we need. We're taking care as best we can of our children. We've got several unique and good approaches. We have the Boys Lodge, we have SAFT, we have Jesse's House, we have CASA, and we contribute a good deal of money and spend a good deal of time trying to make sure that the organizations that we support buttress the justice system, because we're guided by Judge Jackson a lot on that, which then keep court costs down or other kinds of costs down. So the issues, though, to me, continue to be water, where to get more of it, because even with the new contract, we're going to need more water. They continue to be transportation, and they continue to be conformance to the UDC, because I personally believe that we got into this pretty good shape that we're in for a number of reasons, but not least of which is that by sticking largely to the standards that we have for what we expect of developers and builders to come here has caused this county to grow and also caused it to be still a desirable place where builders are still coming, where they aren't coming to a lot of other counties in order to build new houses or take over some of the green pipe farms. And that's nice.
Thanks. All right, thank you everyone for your questions and for your patience, allowing everybody to provide their two cents.
Can I just make one statement?
No.
Oh, no.
Jack Leeson, Smart Growth, Forsyth. I would just like to let all the candidates know how short 3 minutes felt to you. I go up and I speak, everybody who goes, they see me speak all the time. I just want you to understand now how short 3 minutes feels.
You don't realize how long 3 minutes is.
That's good.
We're done?
Okay, it's up to you guys, but I would like to give the candidates 1 minute each to do their closing statement. But you can tell them no.
If we stand so we can just.
Yeah, okay, so let's start with District 4. Then we'll do District 5, and we'll end with District 2. Cindy, you go first, and we'll just go straight down the line. And why don't you come up here, because you're addressing everybody.
I want to thank you all for coming, especially you that hung around to the very end. You deserve some type of a medal, pat on the back. I thank all of you that participate in Smart Growth. I applaud any community activists or community involvement where people, I think it makes us all better. And that's why I applaud transparency in government. I love to see people engaged, and I think that's what makes our community all that it can be and helps us all to be better. We might not always agree, but we can agree to disagree, and hopefully we can see each other's side and make our community and our world a little bit better. So I thank you. I don't know how many people are in here from District 4. I think we all have a lot of, we share a lot of common interests. Let me talk to you. Me and you will go right there and talk to me. Stay away. But I want to, I hope that you will consider, I hope you will consider voting for me. I promise that I will do I will be honest, I will be fair, and I'll do a good job for you. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time tonight. Like you said, this has been a long one or a late one, so thank you very much for sticking it out. BillMulrooney.com, go to my website to see my history, my ideas, my thoughts on all the issues, water and lost and 25% impervious. Just leave you with this, it's kind of strange that I'm actually speaking before Mr. Hubbard here, because normally in these things, it's become I'm the last guy. Believe it or not, Mulrooney is the last person alphabetically among the five candidates for District 4. So I have a new way of thinking. When you get to the ballot and you're looking at who to vote for, just go straight to the bottom of the list. Vote none of the above. Yeah. Have a good night.
Somebody wrong one time is none of the above, didn't it? And it I'd like to thank everyone for coming out tonight and taking time out of your busy schedule and allowing us this opportunity. I tell you, I love the camp, and I see things will one day turn around and we'll be back going just like we was. So don't get discouraged, mainly. And let's just all work together and continue to go forward. And as far as everybody that has stuck around for the whole duration, I want to thank you. And there's plenty of brownies and still some cookies and some coffee left for your prize. But we do thank y'all. And whenever we get down to July 31st, we would appreciate your vote and your support. And I believe you'll be very happy with the job that I will do for you to represent you. Thank you.
I too want to thank you for coming out, and in particular for hanging in there tonight. It dwindled down pretty quickly, but you guys are real troopers, so I appreciate that. You know, to me, this is really what this is all about. It's about getting stakeholders, you know, folks like yourself, people like us, people like Smart Growth in the same room talking about issues. And that's what I want to say to you in my closing remarks, okay? Things are going to get interesting from here to July 31st. This is the important time to participate. This is not about good and evil, at least not from my perspective. I'm not going to make it about that. This is about issues, people and their ideas, and working hard for you. Okay? I'm up here for the same reason that you're there. It's that simple. Now, this takes a little bit more personal courage to get up on this side of the podium, but I'm willing to do it. You know, I think I've got thick skin, but I'm only up here for you. And so what I ask all of you that came here tonight to do is at least show up on July 31st.
Yeah.
That's the important thing. Exercise your right to vote. There are a lot of people out there in this world doing difficult things in god-awful places so that you can go to that poll on the 31st, and that's all I can ask of you. Thank you.
I do agree it's about getting in the same room together. The issue is about voting, and it's also about voting for somebody who has the time and commitment to do what you would like them to do. The first time I ran for at least a year, I went to virtually every single commissioner work session and commissioner meeting before I was put in a position to be able to do anything. Some of my opponent's time has not been able to be given granted to do anything like that because he has a job. I'm retired. I have been retired. He's got a business which he has to tend to. So you need to vote for somebody who has the time and has shown the commitment and has the experience. But to help you to do that, I meant to bring my other thing. My last name is Boff. It's like turn off the light with the B in front of it. And when you go to vote, it's best one for Forsyth or best one for five, District 5, Jim Boff. Thank you.
You know, they're often maligned, but they do a great job. They bring issues up that you're going to have to deal with. So whether you're an environmentalist or a developer, the key to success here and not making the same mistakes that other counties have made is a balanced approach. We've got to listen to all sides and come up with the best solution so we don't become like a Gwinnett County or a DeKalb County. And I grew up in Cobb County, so I've seen it happen. That balance is so important. So we can learn from the mistakes that have been made in other counties and just not make the same ones, because we're uniquely positioned to be one of the premier counties into the 21st century that's ever been. And I say that without any kind of embellishment. So I have plenty of time to do this because I'm retired. I am looking for a job. So I'm going to need something to do, so I would appreciate your support. Early voting July 9th, and vote D. Brown, and hopefully I'll get a chance to make a difference. Thank you.
Do I get like 15 minutes, Bob?
Yes. Three.
Sorry. Well, first of all, I'd like to thank you all. I'd like to thank you for your interest in Forsyth County government. When I first spoke this evening, the first thing I said was that, you know, it began 8 years ago. That's when I decided I was going to run because I wanted to make a difference. And I want to tell you the state of the Board of Commissioners back then was we had three races in District 5, 2, and 4, and all of the incumbents wouldn't run. There's something to be said for stability in government on a local issue, on a local level. We're the fastest growing county in the state of Georgia. There's a reason for that. It's because people want to live here. We do things right. I said when I first sat down, or when I first spoke, that it was about involving the public. On Saturday, State Attorney General Sam Owens came here and reaffirmed his commitment to me by saying that I was committed to open and transparent government, and I have set a high standard of service and dedication for my fellow commissioners across the state of Georgia. I've just always tried to involve people, whether I meet them in a dirt parking lot or in this type of forum, we'll work it out.
Questions outside.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.